This is Vikash from Weightgenius, and today we are going to see how to use CAN protocol with Arduino. Actually, Arduino doesn't have the onboard CAN controller, so for this we are going to use MCP2515 as the CAN controller, and along with we'll use another IC for CAN transistor. So in this we are going to see like how to communicate between two Arduino modules by using CAN protocol. So basically CAN protocols are used like in vehicles for intercommunication. Okay. So let's see how to use it. Let's check it out. So guys, this is a MCP2515 based CAN controller module which is having MCP2515, CAN interface controller and one transceiver. So basically this module has SPI interface at one side and CAN interface at other side, and it is having two jumpers over here which can be used to like provide the required impedance for the CAN bus. So to connect it, we simply need to plug the FRC cable to the SPI port of your MCP2515. If not to get, you can omit the INT pin, interrupt pin. Okay. And over here, you can just plug into, first pin is your VCC, so you can plug into the VCC supply of your Arduino. Next is your ground. So over here, you can see as soon as I plugged in my power supply to the MCP2515 module, the LED power indicator over the MCP2515 module is glowing. So next is your connecting the other four pins of the SPI interface to the board. So for this tutorial, we are going to tag pin number 10 as the CS pin for the MCP2515 module. Actually, you can take any other GPIO pin for the CS pin, but I am just taking 10. Then connect the SCK pin to the pin number 13 of your Arduino, MISO pin to the pin number 12, MOSI pin to the pin number 11. So like this, you can connect one MCP2515 module to one Arduino, and you can just replicate it for the another Arduino. And between the two Arduino, you can simply connect the CAN interface of the MCP2515 module. So CAN high goes to CAN high of other board, and CAN low goes to CAN low of other board. So that's all about connecting MCP2515 to the Arduino. Let's get back to the IDE and see how to like interact with this controller and send data between one Arduino and another. So at the end, I'll have a demo where I'll show you like communicating between two Arduino using this. And for this, we are going to use the Switch Studio CAN library. So let's get back to the IDE.
So let's start with downloading the Switch Studio CAN library for our Arduino. So you can just Google it for it and follow the GitHub link over here. And as usual, you need to simply download the zip file over here. So after completion of download, just navigate to the folder, unzip it, and copy the file to the location where your Arduino is located. So for me, it's in C drive. So go to the drive, into the Arduino folder, go to the libraries, and over here simply paste the folder. Now let's open up the Arduino IDE. And navigate to examples, and over here you can see CAN bus shield master, and over here you can just click on the send application, or you can just open up the send blink example Okay, this application is for the standard Arduino board. So as you know, for this like demo, you need two Arduinos. So one will be act as sender and another one will act as receiver. So coming to it, it's a simple application that like having for standard header files. And over here, you need to change the SPI CS pin to pin whichever you have connected to your CS pin of MCP2515 module. So as we have connected to pin number 10, we need to change it to 10. Then it has defined some variables, and over here it has created a scan object. Then over here there's just serial port initialization, and again over here it just checks for initialization of the scan controller module, and it initializes with baud rate 500 kbps. Over here you can change the variable according to your need, and if it successfully initializes, then it comes to the next step or next command, that is it prints out that scan bus still needs to escape, and it has taken some array, and inside the loop it just sending the message buffer to the receiver Arduino. The send message buffer command takes four parameters. First one is the ID of the sender, second is the type of frame, which is like 0 is for standard frame. Third parameter is the length of data which we are sending, and fourth is the data buffer. Then for another Arduino, we need to open up the receive blink program. So over here also everything is same, but just here for this actually everything is same with the sender Arduino, but inside the loop actually the code changes. So over here it waits for the arrival of packet in the CAN interface. Like whenever it receives the packet, this statement comes true, and the CAN object reads the message buffer. And over here you can just print the CAN ID, and it will print from like the data got from the ID or whatever CAN ID it has received the data from. And this actually prints out the ID whichever we sent from over here. Like over here we sent 0470, that's the ID of the sender Arduino. So over here whenever you run this application on the different Arduino, it will print 0470 into the serial buffer or serial console, and it just takes the length of data whichever it has got on the receiver buffer, and it prints out the data. So it's a simple blinking application which it sends data from sender to the receiver. So guys, this is a simple like interface where we are sending some data to the another Arduino through the CAN interface. And you can explore the other examples also, and you can check those out. That's all with the IDE. So now let's check a demo of communication of between two Arduino. So just let's check it out how it works.
Hi, I am Jivan Mr. Mohanty, and I am going to introduce you how to use CAN protocol with our Arduino. Okay, so this is my CAN device. Okay, this consists of a CAN transceiver called MCP2515 and a transceiver called S2551. Okay, so these are the CAN box. Okay, one is CAN high and another is CAN low. Okay, so these are having a baud rate of 11,500. Okay, so this connect with the Arduino with SPI protocol. So with SPI protocol we have the pin with clock, serial input, serial output and chip select. So as we are using the latest revision of Arduino IDE called as 6.5, so we have set the default pin of chip select to 10 of the Arduino Uno. 10. Okay. So you are in the library.
Seed studio can.
Can seed. Okay, then it has inbuilt examples like receiving to receive the LED upon receiving of some data and receive check whether it is receiving or not data and send sendly. So these are the some examples. So into one we convert it as a sender and another Arduino as a receiver. So the sender has the send link. Okay. So the receiver has receipt check. Okay, and this is the program and let's see the output. So this is the output and this is the input. So it is sending some signal default data in blue. Okay. And this is getting data through the CAN bus. So we can use this device to debug our vehicle equivalent applications like the speed variation, the combustion rate, the acceleration rate, etc. Okay, so we can easily hack our vehicle and get control over it easily. So this is the way we can hack our vehicles using Arduino Uno. It's a very simple device. Thank you.
Hey guys, it's me once again and I hope you have liked my video. And don't forget to put the thumbs up button if you have liked it and put your comments down below. And if you have if you are new to my channel and you want latest content, just subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys, thanks for watching.